Hello guys, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video, we are going to be putting free Todoist versus Any.Do Premium head to head, giving you an idea of what these applications are like in Premium versus the free edition. So guys, I'm really excited for this video, so let's dive in. So today's video has been kindly sponsored by Skillshare. For those who don't know, Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes in design, business, technology, and more. They've kindly jumped in and sponsored today's video. It's awesome to have them as a sponsor here on the channel because I'm a user myself, as well as a teacher, and have been for many years now. I remember when I was 16 or 17, I benefited massively from jumping in on the classes because there were experts in the field of the skills I was learning. And I remember there were some classes on there that got me into productivity and where I am today. If you want an annual subscription, it's less than $10 a month. And the great thing is you get access to all of the classes on there, so you can learn pretty much anything you'd like across the year. This is perfect for 2019 that's just around the corner. Remember guys, I'm on Skillshare too as a teacher, so you can benefit from 5 classes. Over 1,000 students have jumped on the classes already, which is absolutely amazing. For the first 500 people who sign up to the link below, they'll get a 2 months free trial. So do sign up in the link below. So we are putting the two head to head. Let's first give a little bit of an outline to the applications. I would say Todoist is more regarded as the advanced application, and Any.Do is suited more for list creators and personal use. But Todoist has been out for quite a while now, same with Any.Do, and they're priced roughly around the same mark. Now, Any.Do in the last couple of months have really been pressing on the new design, trying to make it as competitive as it is against Todoist. So we'll be reviewing the features side of stuff. Let's talk about Any.Do first. Any.Do Premium is $2.99 per month billed annually. So that works out about $36 per year. They have a web beta, and the premium membership outlines a few of these features. So let's start with the first feature. First feature is the ability to color your tasks, and that's the ability to organize them with labels that are colored. So that's a neat way to be able to visually organize your tasks in your inbox or whether they're in projects. You've also got location-based reminders too. Unlimited attachments allows you to upload any files or images, whatever you like, as well as custom themes to give you a bit more of a personalized workspace and area. Now you've also have customized recurring tasks, which is something that a lot of people like, the ability to really go into detail every Thursday at 4:30 PM, whatever it is, and unlimited collaboration because you can share between lists. Now Any.Do is available on a fair amount of platforms. That's one thing I'd give it to as well. It's one of the very cross-platform resources. It's available on Android, iPhone, iPad, Mac, Web, Siri, Amazon Echo, or Amazon Alexa, that's what it's called. Google Assistant is coming soon, Windows, Chrome, Firefox is coming soon, and Apple Watch, as well as Wear OS, Slack, and desktop. Todoist Premium is $29 now, or actually $36 after the 30th of November. Now inside of Todoist Free, you do get recurring due dates, subtasks and projects, priority levels, as well as 80 active projects and 5 people per project. Now in terms of how they compare, Todoist is cheaper right now and still provides a similar experience. I'd say that Any.Do compares with price, but not by features. I would say overall, you probably get more value in Todoist Premium if you're going for it than the likes of Any.Do. But again, that's up to your preference. So in terms of comparison with Any.Do Premium, color your tasks is essentially labels inside of Todoist, and Todoist does not have this in free, but it does have the ability to prioritize and coordinate your project color. So that, I guess, is the ability to color to some extent. Now again, location-based reminders, unlimited attachments are both locked inside of Premium, so you won't be getting that inside of Todoist Free. Customized themes are available inside of Todoist Free, although you do have a few limited options. You do have customized recurring tasks as the ability to create recurring due dates inside of Todoist Free. Now, although you don't get unlimited collaboration, you get 5 people per project inside of Todoist Free, which is a massive bonus. But the one thing I'd say that Any.Do does have in their free version is a calendar function, and that's one feature a lot of people like. Also, the ability to use grocery lists too, which is a new feature that smartly organizes all of your grocery items. Now, in terms of thoughts, if you're looking for the most value for what you pay, I would say Todoist is the best for that if you're gonna go for premium. But again, if you're looking at Any.Do premium versus Todoist free, I would say that Any.Do definitely has a slight edge here, only because of their recent designs, but it's not too far off Todoist free. And again, you're not paying $36 per year per user. Now again, I would say that Any.Do is much more of a relaxed solution. And the thing that I don't talk about on this channel that much is that it is a strong solution, especially for those casual to-do list application users and those who want a bit of a different experience from the traditional tick-tick and Todoist options. Anyway guys, hopefully that gave you a nice outline of free Todoist versus premium Any.Do. I will be doing hopefully more features on this, so feel free to pop your recommendations below. And a big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Anyway guys, big thanks for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.